Welcome back to episode 64 of the vlog. Thank you guys so much for watching these videos. Today we are traveling to go play Fresno in Fresno. So drop a like, drop a comment, cue the vlog. A few months ago, I made a video about how I got to play D1 college baseball. The video ended up doing pretty well, so I figured I might as well make another one. I've been at the University of San Francisco for the last 3.5 years now. I've been through COVID, them canceling my first ever college baseball season, online classes, and a whole bunch more. But at the end of the day, I'm glad USF was the school that took a chance on me to play baseball at the college level. Tyler and I are preparing for the road trip today. This was the sandwich place that was an 8 out of 10. Tyler, how are we feeling?
What's your rating?
Yeah, it's probably a solid 8, but Bite Me's way better than this one.
We're not getting fed before this trip, so the next time we will be eating from the team is going to be around 5 p.m. before the game starts. So that means we have around 5 or 6 hours before we have our next meal, which is why we're getting sandwiches right now. It is 11:22 right now, and the bus leaves at, I think, 12:15. So we got like 45 minutes to an hour to kind of get everything settled and prepared before we have to go. We're young, dumb, young, young, dumb, and broke. Young, dumb, young, young, dumb, and broke. Young, dumb, young, young, dumb, and broke. Young, dumb, broke. So everybody gets assigned a job when we go on a travel trip like this. Will and I got the luxury of getting the hardest job.
Which is what, Will?
We are transporting the Husky to Fresno, California.
How much do you think this thing weighs? Yes.
So in my last video, I asked you guys to comment anything that you guys want to see for this week's video. One person commented that they kind of want to listen to my recruiting story and how I got to play D1 baseball. So that's kind of what this video is going to be about today. And we're also just going to film a travel vlog as we're filming as well, too.
So what'd you say? Bring it up to right there?
I was just thinking we bring it up there, open the gate, and then walk right up.
Still not great, but here we are.
We have the opportunity to transport the Husky. I spoke wrong before.
Everybody's story to get into college baseball is always a little bit different. Mine was struggling to find just one school who would take a chance on me, pretty much. I always knew that I wanted to play college baseball when I was still finishing up my senior year of high school. The only problem was is that I never threw hard enough. I was always like, my fastball my junior year was around 78 miles per hour to around 82 topping out, so I had no velocity behind. My friends are making fun of me in the background because you're not really throwing that hard if you're throwing 82 miles per hour. But my senior year of high school, I got up to, I think, 86 miles per hour, and I was sitting anywhere from 82, probably 80 miles per hour to like 84, topping out 86. My velocity was very low, and to get into college baseball, you want to be throwing at least like 87, 88 miles per hour. Here, take a seat, Bert. Take a seat. So how hard were you throwing your senior year of high school and your junior year of high school, your four-seam fastballs? How hard were you throwing?
Junior year, I wasn't throwing hard enough. I was only about 80, maybe 81.
Really?
And it took like COVID hitting and me putting in some work, and then I got up to like 86, 87.
By your senior year?
By the senior year, mm-hmm. And that was enough to get me here.
Basically what we're saying is, in order to play college baseball, one of the main things that college coaches look for now is velocity and how hard do you throw. If you want to go D1, you want to throw at least 87, I'd say, right? Probably at least throw 87. If you don't throw at least that velocity, you're going to have a really good secondary pitch that you can just dominate hitters with, and that's kind of what happened in my case, and that's why I got a chance, because my slider was really good for where I was at in high school, and that's the pitch I used probably 80% of the time, and I never threw my fastball because it wasn't good enough to play at the next level. So I'm here with our Friday guy.
Good afternoon. My name is Russell, and I am a wilderness explorer.
You're not Russell, you're Adam.
Okay.
All right. So I'm here with Adam Hsu. How hard were you throwing your senior year of high school?
Oh yeah, let's hear this one.
Like, what got you recruited mostly? What were you known for in high school that scouts loved?
About my sophomore year of high school, I was throwing like 74 to 78. And then by junior year, I was like 80, 81. And then by senior year, I was sitting like 83, 84.
And now tell the viewers right now, you're a sophomore in college. What are we getting up to? What's the hardest you've ever thrown?
So I tend to sit around 90 to 92, but my hardest baseball I've ever thrown in my life was 93.
Wow, my goodness.
Jess, what do we got to say about first road trip of the year?
First road trip of the year, we're excited. We got the entire team waiting for the bus to show up, and it's just taking a long time. Oscar, come in.
How we feeling?
Feeling pretty good. We're waiting for this bus for about 30. Oh, here comes AD. Here comes AD. Everybody act normal. Everybody act normal. Turn off the video. Turn off the video.
There she is.
Luxurious bus of them all. Can't risk it all. Climb to waterfall. We got too involved. I had to make the call. Can't be us. I don't got time. I'm too busy getting mine. Can't risk it all. Climb to waterfall. We got too involved.
We just got to Fresno. We're going to get off the bus in about 5 minutes. It is 4 o'clock right now. The game's supposed to start at 6. So we have about 2 hours to get ready before the game. Will Hearn. Just got to Fresno. Waiting for Will Hearn to help me out with the Husky. Where'd he go? Where'd Will go?
Part 2, let's get this thing. You was cruising with your top down, 4th of July. I was moving down the block. We got caught at the light out my window. I was shooting my shot.
Getting back to the topic, I went to about every single showcase I could possibly think of. I went to like USD, San Jose State, Santa Clara, a tournament down in Arizona. I crushed it there, had like 7 strikeouts per 9 at bats. But the problem was I just didn't throw hard, so the coaches were just never interested in me. I've been on the fast track. Shorty want my heart, but I can never backtrack. I just wanna smash that, hit it, then I pass back. Shorty want my heart, but I can never backtrack. This ain't nothing new. I've been chasing dreams. She been playing games, but there ain't no I in team. I stay with my crew, girl, that's all I need. She been playing games, but there ain't no I. So the rest of the team is doing batting practice right now. The purpose of me coming on the trip obviously was to watch the game, but I was gonna throw a bullpen today as well. Right now we're just waiting for the catcher so I can throw a bullpen on the mound. Here's what we're working with here. So going back to my recruiting story, I went to just about any showcase that you could possibly imagine going to over the summer, and I got to play at a lot of cool college campuses and play in front of coaches, and the only problem, like I said, just my velocity just wasn't there. Okay, so yeah, Lance and I were on a summer ball team together, and luckily the coach for that summer ball team knew one of the coaches here at USF, and he told me that he would vouch for me and kind of make an introduction for me to one of these coaches, and that's what he did. So I reached out to the coach and I said, hey, this is my summer baseball coach and I know you know him. Okay, bye Lance.
Long story short, Jesse's here at USF, so am I.
Long story short, yeah, I'll go more about this later. We're wrapping up BP right now. Going back to my story, I know I'm jumping all over the place here, but my connection to USF, he was a coach, pretty much emailed him. He told me to come out to a showcase, like I said before, paid like $300 to do a showcase, and usually you get to face like 9 hitters or something. Face my 9 hitters, I think I struck out like 6 or 7 dudes, and I believe I topped out at like 86, maybe 87 miles per hour, and after that, the coach came up to me, said we talk more, and he ended up texting me, hey, we're interested, and we want you to come out. Do like a little visit. What's up, James?
Hi, Bob.
Then I came out the next day to San Francisco. 2 days later, did a visit, walked around the campus a little bit, and then got to talk to the head coach, and then after that, they gave me a roster spot. So that's kind of my story and how everything kind of worked out. It was really fast after the showcase. Things just happened immediately, and I was more than willing to take a roster spot at that time and didn't get a scholarship then to play, but at least I was on the team, and that's all I wanted. It is currently 1:40 right now. We just got back from Fresno. Like I said, we ended up losing by 2 today, so it was a tough loss and a tough drive back home. This is what a day in the life is, traveling. We did not get a hotel just because we were close enough to where we could just bus there and bus back on the same day. Hopefully my recruiting process story made sense for you guys. I know it was a little bit all over the place throughout the video, so hopefully the video made sense, but that's gonna end this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys next week. Hello everybody, we're service market. Come on.